So, today we're gonna talk about the Blackburn cult and the rise and fall of it. So the story of the Blackburn cult centers around the two leaders, May Otis Blackburn and her daughter Ruth, and their way to leadership. As you can see here on the screen, I have written some facts about the two girls, and as you can see, we know a lot about May, but not that much about Ruth, and that's because May hid Ruth for a lot of her early years. Like when Ruth was born, she was unknown to a lot of people, like almost everyone except May. As you can see, May was born in 1881 and she died in 1957, making her 76 years old when she died. And she got married quite young, actually. She got married when she was 16 years old to a man called John Wyland, and they had Ruth together. And yeah, they started the cult in 1922, so yeah. The Blackburn cult is pretty, excuse my language, but fucked up. Yeah, because it started with being some kind of movie company they arranged in Origin in Portland because May wanted it to be the new Hollywood, I guess. She wanted Portland to be the new Hollywood. And she tried to make a few films with Ruth being the lead actress, but since it didn't get any attention from outside of Portland, it didn't end up happening. So May Blackburn was very notorious for seducing men into giving her money, and yeah, she did that to a lot of men. For example, after she got separated from her then husband, John Wyland, she got into a relationship with a man called Rudolph. I can't remember his last name, but he was named Rudolph. And she seduced him and made him believe that they were married or something. And she began asking for an allowance once every month. And that allowance would be $150, and that was a lot at that time. By the way, the man in this picture you're seeing right now is her latest husband, May's latest husband, and he is called Ward Blackburn. When Ruth finally became an adult, May had collected enough money from different men to move to Hollywood and Los Angeles, and so they did. And that was the beginning of their life as leaders and the end of their life in Portland. When they finally arrived in Hollywood, Ruth began dancing for a living and making money that way, and May just sat at their house reading the Bible all day. Since Ruth was dancing all the time, she met a lot of people that way, and she also met the first victim of the Blackburn cult, if you can call it that. The first victim of the Blackburn cult was a guy named Arthur, and he was supposed to be her boyfriend, so she could seduce him and take his money that way. And one day, when she was talking to Arthur, her boyfriend at that time, she told him that every night an angel called Gabriel would come down to her and May and dictate a book for them they had to write and publish. The book was supposed to be about an apocalyptic event and what to do if one struck the earth. And the angel Gabriel dictated the girls what they had to write about. In hopes of proving angel Gabriel right, they started this religious new movement called the Blackburn Cult, or the Divine Order of the Royal Arms of the Great Eleven. And it's called the Great Eleven because it was the Great Eleven kings and queens that were supposed to rule after the apocalyptic event had happened on Earth. It was the angel Gabriel who told them to start this order of the divine, of the royal arms of the Great Eleven. And after some time had passed, a lot of people seemed to be interested in it. It was mostly the poor people of Los Angeles who were interested because it could give them a purpose in life. And after some time, some people began missing and disappearing, and also some of them were killed. The most notable victim of the Blackburn Cult was a person named Willow Rhodes, and she was quite young when she died, actually. She got killed by May Otis, of course, and that was supposed to be a way of May Blackburn to show that she could resurrect people from the dead. But when that didn't happen, people started to get suspicious, and one person named Clifford took to the police to tell them about what was going on and to sue May because he was promised some paranormal activity that didn't happen. And he gave all his money to May even though it didn't happen. So he was trying to sue her. But at first that didn't go as planned because the police was like, oh, so you gave this person all your money and then what? Some time passed and more people started to call the police and say, oh, this person is missing and oh, this person disappeared and I haven't heard from this person in a very long time. And they were all connected to the Blackburn Cult. So they started to investigate the case of the Blackburn Cult, and it turns out that a lot of people got killed and disappeared because of May and Ruth. And so May got sent to the Supreme Court of California, where she got life sentence in prison. But she got bailed out at some point, and I can't really remember when. So yeah, and the Blackburn Cult is not really active anymore.